Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another video. I had mentioned in a previous video where I was showing you guys our new production area for DVDs that maybe one day I would take you through the DVD creation process. Well, tonight I'm actually going to make a couple of DVDs, and so I thought I would kind of bring you guys with me and let you see exactly what goes on. So, what we're going to do is we're going to jump downstairs to the production area, and I will show you exactly how a DVD gets created. All right, so what we're going to do today is we're going to make up some Let's Paint White Scars DVD sets. These are really, really cool. Had a little bit of a run on them lately, and I am completely out. So we're going to make three of them, and that should last me about 4 or 5 days. But what we're going to need, our DVD duplicator. I'm going to go ahead and cut that on, let it be powering up while we talk. We also need some blank DVDs, which I've got right over there, conveniently next to the DVD duplicator. And then we got this gem from the archives. This is one of the original master copies for Let's Paint White Scars. You can see very, very old school case. Really, really, really old school stuff. Things are a lot better now. Got some great artwork from Emily and Monley. Really, really awesome looking stuff. This is just junk that I threw together when I first got started doing these DVDs and was doing everything myself. These master copies, this one has actually had, I actually had to replace this one because my original master on this burned out basically. Disc got so scratched up that it wouldn't copy anymore, so I had to replace that part with a new master. But this one, you can see, still the old school labels and everything. And I gotta tell you, this DVD duplicator is a miracle and a half. I did not have this when I first got started doing this, and that's the reason we outsourced, was because the laptop that I utilized at the time to make these masters was the same laptop I would do duplication with. And to do a duplication on, let's say, this set right here, you're looking at about, on that laptop at the time, probably 45 to 55 minutes per DVD. And there's two DVDs in this set, which means you're looking about 2 hours of time if it copies correctly. And a lot of the times they didn't copy correctly on that laptop. And so at one point, I guess it was about 6, 8, 9 months in or so, I can't remember what set we decided to go with the outsourcing on. We sent them out to a printer, and my goodness, I gotta tell you, one of the best decisions we ever made. But unfortunately, times have changed, and we're bringing things back in, which is not necessarily a bad thing. I think it adds a nice little personal touch to stuff. But got three DVDs here. I'm just going to drop these in real quick. This duplicator, I got to tell you, is just a super, super, super investment. All right, just 1, 2, 3, and we're done. I'll come back in about 25, 30 minutes or so, and all three of those should be burned up, ready to go, and I'll take you through the next process. Once the DVDs have been copied, we step into production area number 2, otherwise known as my washer and dryer. When I first started doing this in-house about a month and a half or so ago, I tried doing this at a table, and it didn't really work that well for me, so I wanted somewhere where I could stand up, and this was, surprisingly enough, right across the room, and it works very, very well. So basically what we have here are three discs of each of disc 1 and disc 2, but they're unlabeled, they look unprofessional, and we need to spice them up a little bit. So, to do that, the first step is to get ourselves a DVD cover. And for that, we have this handy-dandy little paper trimmer, and we're just going to cut this puppy right to size. All handcrafted now. All this stuff got a personal touch on it, so I actually kind of like it like this. Might be a little slower, but and it might take a little bit more of my time, but I can control the product a little bit better as far as the quality goes, and like I said, it does have that much more personal touch on it now, as opposed to me just asking my printer to print me 15 or 20 copies of them and send them to me. So, I like it. I really do. But, there we go. There's that. So now, we have a cover for our DVD case. Now we need the case itself. This is a two-disc set, so it's a little case with a swing tray. Love these swing tray cases. I've never been a fan of the ones where you have like two discs, but you've got two of these things where you got one of these on one side and one of them on the other. I just like that movement. There's something elegant about it. So when we brought these in, I asked my former printer, the ones that sold the business, where they initially bought all their supplies, and they were kind enough to let me know. And so I was able to pick up with basically the same stuff that they had been using previously. All right. And all I do is try and line up the spine so you get the nice effect right there. But that gives us a place to put our DVDs. Now we just need the DVDs themselves. So what we're going to do there, I like to get my file folder that's got the labels and covers in them, set it there so that we can have somewhere to put the discs where they don't get scratched. And we pull this puppy out. This is a CD label applicator. We're working with disc one right now. And we just turn it upside down, push it down, and there we have almost a complete DVD. Just need to kind of smooth it down a little bit. Just make sure it's nice and smooth. Then we turn it over, make sure there's no fingerprint marks. If there are, gently rub it with my shirt. All right, looks pretty clean. So this goes in slot one, like so. Now we need disc two. So let's put disc one over here. Pull disc two up. Pull the label off. Put it down. Press. And voila. Just like so, we have both discs now looking nice and professional. Just snap that into the spindle there, and we'll take these extra discs and I'll set them to the side for when I go ahead and complete the rest of this stuff. Now, aside from that, we're basically done. Let me take a look at the back of this one. I didn't look at the back of that one that well. Yeah, you're fine. Just fine. All right. Every DVD we produce gets an insert, as well as a business card. Now we just seal it up. And then we've got these nifty little poly bags here. This was kind of the thing that I was most concerned about when I first started doing this here, was whether or not we would be able to get these like a printer had. But no problem at all. It's basically just a little plastic bag, and it's got a peel-off strip in here. Just peel it off. Fold it down, and now you have a nice, professional-looking product ready to be sent out to somebody's door. So very, very quick, very easy. The whole process of doing a disc like this or a set like this, we can do three of them, and it takes about an hour. Previously, when I had initially started this whole thing, back in 2007, 2008, whenever it was, doing a two-disc set, one copy of it would take close to an hour and a half, probably even longer than that, depending on whether or not I had any missed copies off of the laptop that I was using at the time. So this is just, for me, blazingly fast considering where I initially started from. Again, not quite as convenient as just telling somebody to print something, but I like the idea of giving it that personal touch. And, you know, maybe you've seen something that's interested you. Who knows? But that's all I got for you guys today. I just wanted to kind of take you through the process of DVD creation. I'm going to go ahead and finish up these other two White Scars DVDs. But if you happen to have any comments or questions, feel free to drop those in that comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Again, I really, really do appreciate you guys watching. Thank you for all your support. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you all in the next video.